Hey everybody, it's Jason with Parallel Reality coming back with you today with an article from PJ Media dated July 19th. It says, well, Biden screwed us forever on another damn thing. And I just saw the headline and thought, I wonder what that could be. Because what else is going to go wrong during this dumbass presidential administration? So let's see what it has to say. And the article starts by saying, I was thinking of presidentish Joe Biden on Sunday when I was filling my Jeep's smallish 15-gallon gas tank to the tune of $50 when it still had a couple of gallons left. Remember, because maybe he doesn't, when Biden was emptying our strategic petroleum reserve to force down gas prices in time for the midterms, promising to fill her back up once prices drop low enough? Yeah, about that. The SPR is probably never going to be refilled, according to one report, and maybe not even for the reason that first popped into your mind. Let me set the stage for today's big reveal. So that's already really, really bad news. So let's see. So the SPR was created under President Gerald Ford in 1975, following the 1973-74 Arab oil embargo, which turned out to be just the first of that decade's two major oil shocks. Set in massive salt caverns in Louisiana and Texas, the SPR was supposed to hold enough crude oil, that's 714 million barrels, to help us weather any future embargo. While it was never large enough to do that for any significant time, the SPR's very existence strengthened our geopolitical position versus some very nasty oil producers in places like Iran and Russia. This took until about 2010, that's 35 years, to fill those reservoirs all the way up. It took Dementia Joe just 2 years to cut our reserves in half, down to levels not seen since 1983. So if we're going to get back to where it was, it's going to take us decades to get back to the, 714 million barrels. That's not a pleasant thing to think about. So, and here's, I guess, what it looked like about in terms of what we had, and then just under Biden, took over here and right down. So all this to buy his party a few more votes on Election Day. It could take decades, and there's the answer. It says it could take decades to put it all back, Julianne Geiger warned at Oil Price on Tuesday. Hat tips to Zero Hedge, which is an account you should go follow on Twitter. Says Geiger writes that the SPR could stay half empty forever. That's not a pleasant thought. Says that is, if prices ever come down long enough to make refilling profitable, if those salt caverns even can handle being refilled. I always figured that the Biden cabal was never serious about refilling the SPR. That crew cares about exactly one thing, the next election. If permanently damaging our economic security could save them a few House or Senate seats for just 2 years, well, that's a small price for somebody else to pay. But it was news to me when Geiger noted the issue of infrastructure and feasibility of filling, withdrawing, refilling, etc. of the SPR. She continued, those salt caverns are made of, well, salt, and according to SPR former project manager William Gibson, who spoke to Bloomberg, they were built in the 1970s with the idea that they would last 25 years. They were also designed to be withdrawn and refilled just 5 times, lest the salt caverns simply dissolve. As one former official put it, the caverns were not really intended for the daily ATM type operation. So not only do we not have, or we've taken our product and put it in half, but we stored it in places that can't really handle us going in and out and in and out of it. So, well, maybe we should find a place where we can go in and out and in and out and start refilling this shit, because we kind of going to need to do that, I would think. So the article goes on and says, so even if the Biden cabal were willing to risk sending gas prices back up by pumping more crude into SPR storage, which they're not, they'd have to take into account the advanced age of the facilities, which they won't, and prepare to find replacements, which the green nude eel friends would forbid. All of that is correct, and that was kind of what I had mentioned, but not as eloquently as it is here. So yeah, this is a definite problem. This is, in short, should the geopolitical situation or our domestic oil production suddenly change, either could make us more dependent again on foreign oil. We'd have an SPR cushion no bigger than it was in 1983, during the good old Reagan years. So this is 1983, when our oil needs were much smaller and we were still in the process of wisely adding to the SPR instead of stupidly withdrawing it like our national reserve is the Democrats' private piggy bank. As most days, I managed to laugh or at least to shrug at the short-sighted, destructive, vindictive, petty, and ham-fisted printing morons in the Biden White House, but today they have me seething. I completely agree with that. I mean, if there's another, like, you can't just go, oh yeah, I want people to vote for me, so I'm going to bring your oil prices down by taking it from our reserves. Essentially bribing people, in a way. And then just, you know, this laughing dick face. But yeah, this just pisses me off, too, because it's like, what are you doing? But we got to, I know they're not going to let us get back, but hopefully, you know, Republican gets in office and goes, we need to start pumping and getting those reserves back up just in case. You know, it's always good to have a bit of a cushion lying around just in case something really bad happens, like, you know, oil embargoes, like right here. So let me know what you think about our stupid and incompetent presidential administration below and what they're doing about this. Like, share, subscribe. Talk to you soon. Bye.